coming over here, I had 100 Canadian dollars and I wanted to get a Canadian dollar bank draft. My bank maybe changed my dollars into euros, then changed the euros into dollars again. You wouldn't get away with that in any other industry. If my bank had a hooker, I wouldn't be allowed to bang her. I'd have to bang the last guy who banged her. He'd bang her again. After 4 days, I'd get an invoice, right? I'm slightly upset by that, to be honest. I was arrested recently as well, in Northern Ireland, where Owen is from. It's a slightly scarier part of Ireland. Even the road signs are threatening up there. There's a road sign halfway down a hill in Belfast, and it says, "Try your brakes." And it's halfway down the hill. If your brakes are broken, you will have zoomed by it. You might as well see a sign round the bend that goes, "Ha, ah, wouldn't have done that, you dick." And I got arrested. And the custody sergeant said, "You're being charged with driving in excess of the speed limit. Do you have anything to say?" And I said, "No." And he goes, "Go on, say something. If you say something, Tony, the arresting officer, has to read it out in court. Go on." Now, I should have said this. "You're being charged with driving in excess of the speed limit. Do you have anything to say?" "Nothing. However, I, Constable Tony Jackson, have an admission to make. Sometimes late at night, I touch myself thinking of you, Your Honor." Right? Because he would have to go into court and go, "Ahem, the defendant said nothing. However, I, Constable Tony Jackson, have an admission to make. Sometimes late at night, I touch myself thinking of you." And that would be hilarious, wouldn't it? Right? Slightly cruel, but you know. Cruelty has always existed in the world. The Normans in the 12th century abused their prisoners in much the same way that US forces abused prisoners in Abu Ghraib prison in Iraq. But it's not as much evidence of the Normans because it's a lot harder to pose for a tapestry. than a photograph, one guy slapping another guy going, "Poof, poof, are you getting this? Are you getting this? Oh yeah, that's fantastic. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, oh, the needle loves you. Oh God. Oh, you're very tapestrygenic. Oh, you're fantastic." It's a violent world, you know. There was a Ukrainian in Dublin last year. This is my favorite story recently. Who dumped a body in a suitcase in the Grand Canal. But he got the bus to get to the canal with the suitcase with the body in it. That's fantastic, isn't it? Him getting on the 500C bus going, "Does this bus stop near water?" "Yes." How deep would you say that water is exactly?" "It's about 6 feet." "Excellent, excellent. Two tickets, please." "No, one ticket, one ticket. Ha ha ha. That is a joke, I'm getting fat. Ha 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 ha." Talking of getting fat, my brother was on a flight recently. This is true. And it was half empty. And the air hostess asked for 8 fat people to be moved from the back of the plane to the front of the plane to better balance out the plane. Oh, God. Is there any subtle way you can do that? I would have just tied a Mars bar to a piece of string.
Come on, you chunky bastard, come on. Come on. Screw the diabetes, come on. We've got poutine up the top, come on.
Come on, Sean, it's been an absolute pleasure. You've been lovely. Thanks very much for that.